Okay then, so task B now is slightly different. And so what I've done, I've altered the board round, so instead we're not using these lights anymore, we're going to be using these lights here. So let's just turn them on. So we turn the RCD on. And there you go, you can see those lights have now come on. So it's a slightly less load, so we would expect to see slightly less current. So let's turn the ammeter to the current, and this time we are doing things in reverse. So we're actually going to measure the secondary voltage and the secondary current, and then we work our way backwards. We'll calculate the voltage and current in the primary. So again, we can just take any of the either lead, and we just put it round the clamp on ammeter. And this time it's reading 8.6. Press hold. And it's actually now reading 8.6 amps, and that's the secondary side. So I'll just make a note of that. Let's just turn it off, and we'll also turn off the circuit breaker. And now I'll put it in to the voltage in parallel with the secondary side, turn the voltage on and read the voltage and measure and hold it. And this time it's reading 12.53 volts. So we've done that, and now we can go back and do the calculations. So now we can do the calculations. So we've got here, we've measured the voltage in the secondary and the current in the secondary. This time we need to calculate the voltage and current in the primary. So again, we're going to use the same formula. I'll just write it up here. So we've got the voltage in the primary over voltage in the secondary is equal to the number of turns in the primary over number of turns in the secondary, which is equal to the number to the volt to the current in the secondary over the current in the primary. So to calculate the voltage, we're just going to use that part of the formula. So again, I like to write it all out again. So VP over VS is equal to NP over NS. Okay, so again, we write these down, the figures down on the right hand side, just so it's all clear. So the voltage in the primary, so that's what we want to calculate. The voltage in the secondary is 12.53 volts. The number of turns in the primary and number of turns in the secondary, so again it's exactly the same. So that was 600 to 30, which brings it down to the ratio of 20 over 1, which makes it much more simple. So this time, let's work on this. So VP is what we want to find. So again, I put X there over VS, which was 12.53, is equal to 20 over 1. And this time, all we have to do again to get everything on the top line is we just cross multiply. So 1 times X is just X. So X is equal to 12.53 times 20. So therefore, X is equal, so that's 12.53 times 20, that equal 250.6 volts. So that's what we've calculated it to be, which looks slightly high, but we won't worry about that just yet. And then we will measure the current in the primary side as well. So again, we can go back to the original formula. We can either use VP over VS is equal to IS over IP, which we did previously, or we can do this one. And I think because we did it the other way around, we'll do this one for this one. So we'll write this down. NP over NS is equal to IS over IP. And this is it's IP that we want to find. So we have a ratio NP over, so 20 over 1 is the number of turns in the primary and the secondary, is equal to IS, which we know IS is 8.6, over X, which is IP. So let's write the figures down here. So we know that NP is 20, we know NS is 1, we know IS is 8.6 amps, and we know IP question mark. Just quickly, I'll just notice there that I forgot to write the answer there, so that's 250.6 volts. Let's back to this one. So this time then, we now just cross multiply exactly the same as previously. So that's 1 times 8.6 is equal to 20x. So that's 8.6 is equal to 20x. Okay, so now we need to do a little bit further calculation. So we want x to be on its own. So if we divide this side by 20, we must divide this side by 20. By dividing this side by 20, it cancels out the 20. So x is equal to 8.6 over 20. When I wrote this out here, I should have wrote it, so it should have really been 20x is equal to 8.6. But so now all I've done, I've just flipped it round the other way. So x is on the left-hand side. So x is equal to 8.6 over 20. So x is equal to, again, we'll press the fraction button, and that was 8.6 over 20. Press equals, and that's 0.43 amps. X is equal to 0.43 amps. 0.43 amps. Now, that sounds about right, because of previously, when we had the higher wattage lamps, it was, I think it was it 0.69 amps or something? So we would expect that one to be lower anyway. So what we've done, we have calculated this one, and we have calculated that one. So now all that's left to do is go and re-measure the primary side and compare the results. Okay then, so back on the rig. So let's turn this back on. So this time then, so previously we measured the, initially we measured the current and the voltage in the secondary side. So now we're going to measure the voltage and the current in the primary side. So, simple measuring the current, we just go around one of the loops, let it settle, we take the RMS value, and this time it's reading 0.53 amps. So let's just make a note of that, so that's 0.53 amps. We turn that off. And this time we measure the voltage. Again, the voltage is measured in parallel to the supply. Turn it on. Let it settle. Press hold. And you can see there, 243.6. Let's make a note of that. 243.6. So that's that. So let's just go and look at the results and see what we can make from that. This one is task B. So let's just go through what we did. We've got the secondary that we measured, both the voltage and the current. We then calculated the voltage and the current in the primary. And as you can see, it's laid out nice and clearly, everything all labelled nice and clear, and you can see exactly what we've done. Now, as far as I'm concerned, that is the end of the task, but I took it one step further how we would be doing it in on the assessment, because that's what we would be doing and in the video. So we've actually now measured and we've got the current and the volts, 0.53, 243. Now, as you can see, they are considerably out. So the calculated voltage was 250, the measured voltage was 243, and the same with the current, 0.43, 0.53. Now, the reason because of that, on task A, we did it in the correct order. We measured the primary voltage first and primary current, and then we worked our way through and we got some reasonable results, and we expected to see what we got because of the losses. This time, however, we are calculating the secondary side on task B. We've calculated the secondary side, and then we've worked our way backwards doing the calculations, which don't seem to always work out. Well, they don't work out. And that's why, because we haven't taken into account the losses properly. So we've got a higher voltage and a higher current than a higher voltage and a lower current compared to what we should have had really. But it doesn't really matter. The task for this exercise it's to basically show that you understand the calculations and you understand the process of how to do it, and it's also how to use an ammeter for measuring the current and the voltage. So for the sake of that, I think that's a good task that we've done.